Greetings. I was recently sent the following challenges by a Mohammedan. Basically, you are trying to say that Prophet Muhammad was a false prophet. If Islam was not from God, it must come from Satan. But this is against the teaching of your own Bible. Satan can't talk against themselves. Jesus said, Matthew 12:26, "If Satan drives out Satan, he is divided against himself. How then can his kingdom stand?" You didn't even follow the teachings of Jesus, so how would you follow the teachings of Muhammad? So, I wanted to make a video or two addressing his misunderstanding and misapplication of this verse. First, let's look at the actual scripture passage that he is making mention to. Matthew 12:22, "Then was brought unto him," or Jesus, "one possessed with a devil, blind and dumb. And he healed him, insomuch that the blind and dumb both spake and saw. And all the people were amazed and said, Is not this the son of David?" So the first thing to notice is that a demon-possessed person was brought to Jesus. This person was blind and could not speak. Jesus cast out the demon. That means commanded the demon to leave, and the demon left. The proof the demon left was that the blindness was gone. The man could see, and he could now speak. So the man could see and speak. Jesus had delivered this man from the power of the demon. Matthew 12:24. "But when the Pharisees heard it, they said, This fellow does not cast out devils, but by Beelzebub, the prince of the devils." The Pharisees acknowledged that it took authority to command a demon to leave and have the demon actually obey. But the Pharisees did not want to accept that Jesus had this authority from God. So the Pharisees did what men do. They made up their excuse of what they wanted to believe. They claimed Jesus had authority over the demon because Beelzebub, the prince of demons, had given Jesus that authority. And I am sure, to the willfully ignorant, that dismissive argument was acceptable. But Jesus was about to point out how illogical it actually was. Matthew 12:25, "And Jesus knew their thoughts, and said unto them, Every kingdom divided against itself is brought to desolation. And every city or house divided against itself shall not stand. And if Satan cast out Satan, he is divided against himself. How shall then his kingdom stand?" Notice that Jesus talks about casting out Satan. That means actually forcing his departure and evicting Satan or the demon. Jesus did not simply speak empty words. Jesus did not say, "This poor, blind, dumb soul. Satan is bad. Satan is evil. I condemn Satan's actions." Jesus refuted their argument then with an irrefutable teaching. A house that is divided against itself cannot stand. Matthew 12:26. "And if Satan cast out Satan, he is divided against himself. How shall then his kingdom stand? And if I by Beelzebub cast out devils, by whom do your children cast them out? Therefore they shall be your judges." Jesus then raises the point that Jewish rabbis also cast out demons. And if casting out demons means cooperating with Beelzebub, their claim also judges these others. "But if I cast out devils by the Spirit of God, then the kingdom of God is come unto you." So basically the facts are these. If you have authority to cast out demons, it only comes from one of two places, Satan or God. But this is talking about actual works and not empty words. Consider this example. A house being divided is like two teams building a house. Each day, the day crew puts up another wall. And each night, the night crew tears down the wall and pulls out all the nails. The night crew is destroying the works of the day crew, and the house will never be built. A demon came to blind the man and mute his tongue so the man was dumb. This is the work of Satan in the man's life, to bring damage and suffering to the man. But Jesus came to undo the works of the devil, stopping the suffering and repairing the damage caused in the man's life. Jesus was working against Satan's plan. So Satan's plan in this man's life failed. The man was no longer blind, and the man was no longer mute. He could see, and he could praise God. In this way, Jesus was working against Satan. If Jesus was of Satan's house, Jesus was divided and working against Satan. But let's go back a moment to what the Mohammedan wrote. But this is against the teaching of your own Bible. Satan can't talk against themselves. Now, I'm not critiquing the incorrect English. We understand well enough what this gentleman meant. His point is that Muhammad said things like, Satan is bad, and don't follow Satan. These sound correct, saying bad things about Satan, but they accomplish nothing. Let's go back to the example of the two crews working on the house. Each day, the day crew puts up another wall, and each night, the night crew stands around saying, this house is bad. This wall is crooked. Has the night crew done anything to stop the work of the day crew? No, they have not. They have failed to contribute anything, but they have not undone any of the work of the day crew. So the work of the day crew continues. So how does this relate to our text and the question by the Mohammedan? Saying Satan is bad and saying don't follow Satan are insignificant, empty words, because they do not stop or undo any of Satan's works. So that is the first point when you consider this topic. It is important to notice that this brother was confused, equating saying something as equal with doing it. In summary, for this first video on the topic, the Mohammedan was confused and misquoted the scripture. It said nothing about speaking against Satan. The scripture was actually detailing the proof that Jesus was empowered by God and was not casting out demons as a follower of Satan. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. In the next video on this topic, I want to address Satan's goals and his strategy to achieve those goals.